So hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Saujanya Sane. So are you guys planning to visit Hampi? And if the answer to this question is yes, then this video is for you guys. Because in this video, I will be taking you on a virtual trip to Hampi, and I'm sure that this video will help you guys plan your Hampi trip. But before we begin with our main video, just make sure that you hit the subscribe button as I upload informative and interesting travel videos on a regular basis. So let us begin with our main video. So first thing is first, what is Hampi? What makes it so special? What makes it a UNESCO World Heritage Site? Basically, Hampi is not one place or one monument, but it is an entire city with many monuments. So if you are visiting Hampi for the first time, it is very obvious that you might get confused with regards to the places that you should visit, with regards to the places where you can eat, with regards to the places where you can stay. So do make sure that you watch this video till the end, because I'm very sure by the end of this video, you will have a complete travel guide to Hampi. We had taken our stay options in Sanapur, which is around 22 kilometers from Hampi on the road. Now there are various other options to stay in and around Hampi, but I will be telling you about these options as and when we go ahead in this video. Now the road which connects Sanapur to Hampi is just amazing and magical because of these views. There is something in these views that it takes you back in time. Our decision to choose Sanapur as a stay option, which is relatively far away from Hampi as compared to other options, was totally worth it just because of these amazing views which you get while you are driving from Sanapur to Hampi. So for ease of planning your Hampi trip, I will divide the entire Hampi in two parts. One is the Sacred Center and second is the Royal Center. Now as the name suggests, Sacred Center will belong to all the temples and other monuments. Mostly it is dominated by temples only, and the Royal Center is related to the royal family. Basically it will have all the palaces as well as other monuments which were used by the royal family. On an average, it will take you around 3 days to see Hampi. Matlab, yes, this can obviously change as per your choices, but yes, we covered entire Hampi in 3 days. It took us 2 days to cover the Sacred Center and it took us 1 day to cover the Royal Center. So on the first day of our trip, we started with the Sacred Center, and the first destination of our trip was the majestic Vijay Vitthal Temple. One of the interesting facts which we came to know about this temple from one of the guides there is that this temple does not have an idol inside. That is, the Vitthal temple does not have a Vitthal idol inside. Now, do you know where can you find this idol? This idol is found in Pandharpur in Maharashtra, the state from which we came from. Isn't it amazing? The temple is really amazing and has some mind-blowing sculptures. Now, there are two more things in the premises of this temple which will blow your mind. First is the famous stone chariot, and second is the musical pillars. The stone chariot is one of the famous monuments in Hampi. It's like, agar ye nahi dekha, to Hampi nahi dekha. After Vitthal Mandir, we went to the second destination where you can actually see two places. First is the Narasimha statue and second is the Badavi Linga. Now, one more question which can come to your mind is that how do you travel from one monument to another monument in Hampi? As I have said in the beginning of the video, Hampi is not one small place or one small monument, but it's an entire city. So it is, at times it can be difficult to travel from one place to another, especially if you don't have an option like we had. We actually did a bike ride from Mumbai to Hampi, so we could easily travel within Hampi. So the next best option is that you can hire rickshaw over here. In addition to that, you can also hire bicycles or bikes in Hampi, which you can get near Virupaksha temple. So the next destination where we went was the Krishna temple, which is very much near from the Badavi Linga and Narasimha statue. This is one of the must visit temples in Hampi due to its beautiful carvings. If you are visiting Krishna temple, you can also see the Hampi Bazaar, which is right opposite to the Sri Krishna temple. Now it was almost time for lunch on the first day of our trip. There are many options in Hampi, right from cafes to restaurants to street food. But if you ask my suggestion, or I'm very sure that anyone who visits Hampi, if you ask him where is that I should eat in Hampi, I'm very sure he will tell you only and only one place, that is the Mango Tree Restaurant. Now this is a pure vegetarian restaurant, so just imagine me being a pure non-vegetarian, if I am recommending you this place has to be good. After our lunch, we just decided to relax a bit and then go to the Hemakuta Hills to enjoy a beautiful sunset. The Hemakuta Hills gives a beautiful view of the Virupaksha Temple, as you can see it on your screen right now. We just relaxed over here and had to eventually leave by 6 p.m. as majority of the monuments in Hampi shut down by 6 p.m. So do make sure that whenever you're planning your trip, you have to consider this point, and it is very important. The second day of our trip, we began with one of the most visited temples of Hampi, and it is the Virupaksha Temple. One of the notable features of the Virupaksha Temple is the Gopura, or the Gopuram of the temple. A Gopura is basically the tall structure which you can see at the entrance of every South Indian temple. If you are visiting the Virupaksha Temple, do make sure that you meet Lakshmi. Now, who is Lakshmi? Have a look. Now in the beginning of the video, I had said about a few additional options to stay in Hampi. Now these additional options you can find near Virupaksha Temple. Basically there is an area which is kind of a bazaar over here. Here you can find items for shopping as well. So in this bazaar there are certain places which are on rent, so you can stay over here as well. After Virupaksha Temple, we had to go to see the monolithic bull, which is right opposite to the Virupaksha Temple. The word monolith means it is carved out of a single stone. It is an amazing structure which you can see in Hampi. From monolithic bull, we had to go to see the Achyutaraya Temple. Now the Achyutaraya Temple is also a highlight of Hampi. It is a very beautiful temple. Just behind the monolithic bull, there are certain stairs, okay, that will take you to a point from where you can go to the Achyutaraya Temple. But before you actually go to the temple, just make sure that you stop for a while and see this amazing view of Virupaksha Temple, which you will get to see from these stairs. The Achyutaraya Temple is one of the finest and one of the most beautiful temples in Hampi, as you can see in this video. After our lunch on the second day in Hampi, we just went near the Tungabhadra River. We sat over there and relaxed. We just enjoyed the beautiful view of the river. Alternatively, what you can do is that you can also enjoy the Coracle ride in Tungabhadra River. Now I know it is a must do thing in Hampi, but we did not do it. But any which ways, we had a very good time over there. We just sat and we just enjoyed the beautiful view of the Tungabhadra River. After relaxing near the Tungabhadra River, we went to see a very interesting spot by the name called as Sugriva's Cave, which has a very significant role to play in Ramayana. Sugriva, who was the younger brother of Vali, the king of Kishkindha, met Lord Rama at this very place. So this place is very, very important from the point of view of Ramayana. So after visiting the Sugriva's cave, it was time to enjoy a beautiful sunset in Hampi. So I would recommend that you should see the sunset on day 2 from Matanga Hill. You will have to climb a bit to reach to the top of Matanga Hill, but I think it is totally worth it. To be very frank, we could not go over here due to some reason. It was in our schedule, but due to some reason we had to skip this particular place. But yes, I would recommend that you see the sunset on the second day of your trip from this very place. So this is where our day 2 ends in Hampi and also the Sacred Center. Now I am very sure I may have missed a few points over here, that is in the Sacred Center. But whatever I have covered in this video are the most important ones. Day 3 of the trip was totally dedicated to the Royal Center, and I'm very sure that one day is enough for you to see all the spots in the Royal Center. So the moment you're entering in the Royal Center, the first place that you will see is the Queen's Bath. When we went over here, there was some construction work that was going on over here, but still we had a good time over here and it is definitely a must visit. So after visiting the Queen's Bath, we went inside the royal enclosure. The first thing which we saw after entering the royal enclosure was this structure which had some amazing carvings on it. When we asked one of the locals over there, he said that this place was meant for various religious activities in the past, okay. Now I will give the name of this particular place in the caption. It is very difficult to pronounce, that is why I am not trying to pronounce it, but I will give that name in the captions. Later we went to see one of the best structures in Hampi. If you will ask me, I think it is not one of the best structure, it is the best structure in Hampi, and it is this step well, also called as the Pushkarani. Now there are many step wells in Hampi, but this particular step well in the royal enclosure, it is the best, and I need not tell you why. I mean, just take a look at this beauty. Now there are many other monuments in the Royal Center, but before visiting those monuments, we went to see one temple which is a part of the Royal Enclosure. Basically, one part of Sacred Center, or rather one temple of Sacred Center is there in the Royal Center, and I think it is the best temple in Hampi, again as per my choice. The name of the temple is the Hazararama Temple, and it is the best according to me because of the carvings which you can see in this video. Now there are three more things which you can see in the Royal Center. All these three things are forming a part of one compound, that is you have to enter one premises, and in the premises you will get to see all the three places. These places are the Queen's Palace, the Lotus Mahal and the Elephant Stable. All the three places are worth visiting, especially the Lotus Mahal and the Elephant Stable. The Elephant Stable was the last location of our Hampi trip. We ended our Hampi trip after this. Now I know there are various other small temples as well as monuments in Hampi which I might not have covered in this particular video. But whatever I have covered in this video, be it Sacred Center or be it Royal Center, all these places are the most important ones as well as the most famous ones which you should visit in Hampi. So I hope that you guys have liked this particular video and this video was helpful for you to plan your Hampi trip. If it was helpful, do let me know in the comment section below that you like this particular video. Do share this video amongst your family and your friends, and also with such people who want to plan their Hampi trip. So guys, that's it from me in this particular video. I hope that you have enjoyed this particular video. So guys, I'm sure we'll meet in the next video. So until next video, bye bye.